Welcome back.
Feeling productive. Okay, so I'm actually filming another video, but that video is gonna take a while. So I thought I would just do this one to get something out there. I've been wanting to do a video like this for the longest time. And today I'm gonna talk about my obsessions. To be specific, my October obsessions. So I don't know when this era of YouTube had this, like, it was a trend. It was like my weekly obsessions, my monthly obsessions. I know people did it on podcasts when I was watching them way back when. I always wanted to film a video like this, so I have a YouTube channel, might as well. If you've never seen a video like this, pretty self-explanatory. It's just saying, this is my favorite this is my favorite that, and it's like my obsessions because, you know, I'm just a girl and I have monthly obsessions. I don't know why I'm yapping so much. I don't know why I need to explain myself, but anyway, let's get started. One thing I really wanted to include into this video was my favorite outfits of this month. Usually I don't really document what I wear to class. Unless it was like last year, I would do like get ready with me videos and they were so much fun. One of the first outfits that I really liked is something that I'm wearing right now. Let me just show you. This is the fit. This was at Salvation Army. It's giving like actual Sawako. She's about to the knee. This is like legit Sawako. Some people say like, oh my god, this is something Sawako would wear, and then they show something that she would never even look at. I don't know where you're getting your information, but I'm right. I'm right. I love these colors. It's like cherry red with like this plum color, and the checkers are so cute. And this next piece is beautiful. So I really love these grandma embroidered detailed sweaters. I just think they're scrumptious, and you know, I would eat them for breakfast if I could eat fabric, but the human body does not allow that unless you're crazy and you're on that one show. It's like my weird obsessions, but this is not a weird obsession. This is a good obsession. This is a healthy obsession. Put my hair back so you can see the details on this thing. It's very like fall. We'll say that. Beautiful embroidery. Just so stunning. So beautiful. And it's like oversized, so it's very comfortable. And I just love this sweater. I love it. Guess where I got this? Wrong. I actually got this down the road. It was like this dumpster site. So there was there was like this big shed with junk, and they do it like every, I'm pretty sure it's over now, because they just took everything out of there and put everything on the street and was like, this is for like a dollar. So I was digging through piles and piles of clothes, digging, and I found this. I got it for $1. $1. Let's talk about my next favorite outfit. I actually posted it on my Instagram and I got a lot of like DMs saying, oh my god, I love your style. And I know, right? Just like look at it. Here it is. Come on, guys. Come on. I'm trying to find like a really cute pair of boots and I found them. It gives me some height because I'm like 5 foot and it's sort of embarrassing some days. So like she gives me that extra inch that I need. Really cute. Oh, I love these. I'll put them in the description below. I layered it with these really cute boot socks that are brown and they have frills. Really cute cream lacy skirt, and I paired it with this beautiful zip-up hoodie with like horses, and I think the brown matched the boots, and then I had a brown tank top underneath, and I really love that outfit. Those are my two favorite outfits from this month of October. So the next monthly obsession would be my favorite songs that I listen to throughout the month. I have this app called Airbuds and it just tracks what I like to listen to per week. I haven't received the monthly update yet for October, but I'm just gonna say the ones that I feel like I listen to the most this month, and that is starting off with Midnight, The Stars and You by Al Boley. He is from the 20s, 30s. I was like obsessed with this man since like back in high school. because I've always loved like 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s music. But Al Boley has like a special place in my heart. I think he died way too soon. Like, he deserves so much more. Like, people don't recognize him. Like, no one's talking about him. There's barely any information about him on the internet. You have to like do a deep dive. But so here's the song. You've probably heard it from The Shining. I actually just watched The Shining this month for the first time. There's like videos of him singing on the internet, and they're just so wholesome. Because like we don't talk about him enough. Another good song from him is Melancholy Baby, and there's like this video of him singing and he's so cute. I'm gonna watch it right here.
Something seems to grip this very heart.
This is my favorite part.
Come to me, my melancholy baby. Just cuddle up and
guys,
go.
Come on. Another one of my favorite songs this month was Alita, What a Game. You guys probably heard of this song. It's so fucking good. What a vibe. Those songs are so vibey. So underrated. Go listen to both of them. My next topic is my favorite drink. And if any of you know me, I'm obsessed with tea. Not drama. I mean, sweet tea as well, but more like loose-leaved hot tea. And I have a favorite blend this month, and that is, shit, I forgot the name. Let me go bring it. Like I said, I'm a big, I collect teas, and this is my favorite loose leaf right now. It's called Rose Garden White Tea, and she is so yummy. She's so fragrant, very sweet, very floral, just very refreshing and very simple, but very, like, flavorful. If you love teas, this is from the Spice Merchant. This is the best place to get all of your loose leaf teas. And I just found out that they do shipping now. If you are very interested in that, just let me know and I will answer any of your comments down below. So going on to the next topic is my favorite snack of the month. Usually I like to snack on popcorn, but that is like that's gonna be my obsession every month because I just consume that thing like it is air. Ranch oyster crackers, they're so easy to make. You just butter ranch seasoning on those things and pop them in the oven, and they're so yummy. Next favorite thing is my favorite thing to bake, and unfortunately I didn't get any footage of this one, but it was my pumpkin roll. I made it for the first time and it was so good. I just ended up making a ton of pumpkin flavored baked goods. So I made these pumpkin chocolate chip cookies. I made pumpkin like icing cookies, and they were just fun to make. Next thing is my favorite hobby of the month, and that would hopefully be reading. I'm trying to read. I'm reading Anne of Green Gables. That was upside down because we'll get into that later. I'm trying to read more because I am chronically online and I need a life. So yeah, maybe I'm gonna read a few of my favorite quotes from this book because Anne is so funny and I relate to her. Like, she is a kindred spirit. And people laugh at me because I use big words. But if you have big ideas, you have to use big words to express them, haven't you? So true. Except my vocabulary is very limited to like two words, cute and pretty. I like related to this one. She's just so funny, bro. Okay. Don't you think it must be a glad thing to be a rose? Wouldn't it be nice if roses could talk? I'm sure that they could tell us such lovely things. Isn't pink the most bewitching color in the world? I love it. but I can't wear it because she thinks that redheads can't wear pink, which is totally false, not factual. Okay, so that is one of my hobbies, reading. Another one of my hobbies would just be spending time in nature. My godmother actually just got a new house, and it's just in the most beautiful location. There's just land and trees, and her neighbors have goats, and I just love to talk to them. Let's move on to the next thing, and that is movies. So my favorite movies at the moment are Phantom of the Opera. If you haven't seen it, I totally recommend. Actually, I'm gonna rewatch it today with a friend because she hasn't seen it like in a long time. I'm usually not a big musical person, but there's only like a limit to how much I can take. I think there's like one song in there I'm like, shut up, this is dumb. But anyway, all the music in there is pretty good. And I was watching a lot of horror movies this month, which I usually don't, but I just rewatched the X trilogy, and Pearl just is so good. She's so funny. She's just a girl. She just had a bad day, guys. Okay. Favorite TV shows has to be Anne with an E. Obsessed with, this was one of my top three monthly obsessions, Anne with an E, to the point where I actually wanted to read it. Isn't that insane? So if you haven't seen Anne with an E, it is just a gorgeous TV series. I especially love the first season. It's about an orphan girl who eventually becomes adopted by this family. The value of family and how important family can be to a person, especially to a young girl. So yeah, there's so many funny quotes in that movie. Oh my god, she's such a vibe. My next favorite TV show is Queen's Gambit with Anya Taylor-Joy. Anya. I heard in an interview it's pronounced Anya. So Anya Taylor-Joy. A TV show is about an orphan. Wow, so many orphans. Okay. What basically, it's about this orphan who plays chess, and it's just like, it's not just about chess, it's like about so many different things. Like if you see it from the outside view, you're like, chess, ugh, boring, why would I watch that show? But it's so good. Favorite cartoons. This month I recently started watching cartoons before bed, because like, to be specific, like black and white cartoons are just really old-timey cartoons. I started watching Betty Boop and Felix the Cat. Felix the Cat is so good, and I've been watching it for God knows how long. And it's just great to watch something that you haven't seen in so long, because I would just sit there and watch the episodes and I would be like, oh my gosh, I like remember this, like scene by scene, I remember this, which is so crazy to say, because I don't know when I watched it, maybe when I was like 8. Anyway, let's move on to the next topic. That is favorite YouTube channels. I thought I'd just add this into the list because I do spend a lot of time on YouTube. So my first favorite channel is Rachel Maxey. I've been following her since her old days. She's so funny. Her content is so good, and I can just only hope to be that good on YouTube. She does a lot of vintage DIY content. She's really funny. She's like so hysterical. Like I like pee when I watch her YouTube videos because she's so funny. And if you haven't checked her out, make sure you do. Another one is Our Cottage Life. You can tell how, I don't remember her name, but she puts so much effort into her YouTube videos. They're just stunning to look at. And they're just a great way to wind down before bed. I love that channel. It's just so wholesome and cute. So go check those channels out. I will link them down below. The next thing I wanted to put on here is my favorite lip product, which I have right here. And I've had this for like a year maybe. And it's just such a perfect autumn shade. It's from Can Make Tokyo. And it's called Melty Luminous Rouge, and the color is 05. So let me put that on for you. So cute, am I right? Okay, that is my favorite lip product of October. So yeah, moving on to my favorite blush. I just love this blush. And she is so underrated. Are my makeup bags so cute? I'll link them down below. And this one is my favorite from my friend's Etsy shop. She has dresses and purses and just makeup bags, and they're all such good quality. This is my favorite blush. As you can tell, she is loved. The label literally came off because I just use it so much. This is the Burt's Bees All Aglow Lip and Cheek Stick. The number is 1251 Peony Pole. Peony, the flower. But I have a lot of blush on. But this is the blush I use, and she's a cream stick. Always use this blush. Oh, yep, those are my favorite beauty products of this month. Another favorite thing is a favorite accessory from this month. So my favorite earrings, they match this necklace that I wear every day. And if you don't know, this is called a miraculous metal. I actually have two of them on here. I just wear it every day because the significance of it. When I found these, I was like, they're so gorgeous and I need them. They match my necklace. And then the back has the same indent for the miraculous metal. So just gorgeous. Let me put them on. Like, come on guys. It just matches so perfectly, but so cute. One of my favorite other obsessions of this month is my favorite app, like iPhone app, and that is Talkbook. I am not sponsored, by the way. It's basically just like a digital diary where you can record yourself talking about like anything, and I'm on this constantly. I've been using it for about 2 to 3 months now, and it's just like fun to like capture these videos or like just to rant to myself. I really suggest it to anyone who just has a lot of words and just loves to talk. My last and final October obsessions, or my just weird obsessions of the month, I find that I usually have these. Sometimes they last for a month, sometimes they last for 2 weeks, sometimes they last for 2 months. I think my first obsession, like weird obsession, was Anne of Green Gables, but I already talked about that. So moving on to the next one, which is Lord of the Rings. I am a Lord of the Rings fan, and you just like, during this time of year, you have to watch it because it is required, and that goes with the that goes with the edits, bro, on TikTok. I have a few favorite edits. Goes for my Thranduil edits, my Keeley and Feely edits, and my Legolas edits, along with so many others, because like Aragorn is hot as well. But other than that, Lord of the Rings is just so good. Like both Lord of the Rings and The Hobbit. So good that I got books from, and aren't they so cute? I can't wait to start reading them. I'm sort of scared too, because I think I'm gonna have to read it with an audiobook. But yeah, I got the books, and once I'm done with my first Anne of Green Gables book, I will start reading The Hobbit. And I got the next series with Anne of Green Gables. So a lot of reading is in store for me this year, and I hope I can finish them, because I think I would just be very proud of myself. Read the goddamn books. Read the books. I low-key want to show you the edits because they're just so good. No way. I literally uploaded this edit to my Google Drive so I can watch on my computer. You guys will thank me. You guys will thank me. Guys, come on, guys, come on. You can see why I'm obsessed with this, right? Besides The Hot Man, the story's just good. And if you haven't seen, like, Lord of the Rings, what the heck are you? What rock are you living under? That's crazy. That's a little bit of a red flag. My last obsession, my last final obsession, my most weird obsession this month. I wouldn't say it's weird, but I would just say it was a heavy obsession this month. And so many videos of this were consumed. So many hours I put research into this. And that obsession is Blythe dolls. Blythe dolls. Blythe dolls. Blythe dolls. Guys, come on. Come on. Come on. You can't. Okay. They're so cute. Like, there's no reason for you to say that they're ugly. Even, like, the dolls, when they're not customized, they're cute. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, recently, I started this journey of doing my own customized Blythe doll. Here she is. She looks a little scary right now. But we're working on this together. It's you and me, babe. It's you and me. And yeah, that's the video I'm filming next. So if you want to watch me customize my own Blythe doll, please subscribe. I'll say this. Just look out for my next video. Look out for my next video if you want to see that. Good content coming. I think I decided a name, and that is Nicolette, because I am Nicole or Nikki, and she is my mini me. So little Nicole, Nicolette, and she's gonna be so cute. I'll just show you one of her dresses. Guys. And we even have matching socks, because I wear frilly socks all the time. She has matching frilly socks. I think that's all. I think that's all I wanted to say. And I really found this, like, this was pretty fun, because I'm talking about things I like. So yeah, this was a lot of fun. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for that next video update. I don't know how to end this video.